हेलो, वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट गेट 1996 ईसी पेपर एंड दिस क्वेश्चन इज रिलेटेड टू एनालॉग सर्किट्स. लुक एट द सर्किट शोन. इन द सर्किट गिवन N इज ए फाइनाइट गेन एम्पलीफायर विथ ए गेन ऑफ K. So network N is going to be a finite gain amplifier with having a gain value of K, and it has very large input impedance and very low output impedance. We are going to calculate the input impedance of this feedback amplifier with the feedback impedance Z connected as shown. So we are going to calculate what is the value of input impedance of this feedback amplifier. So you can think in this way. This is what Zin. We are going to calculate this value. Input impedance is nothing but it is the ratio of input voltage to input current. If Vi is going to be input voltage at that time, how much current is coming from this one? Assume it as Ii. So the ratio of Vi divided by Ii is nothing but input impedance. And it has given that one, this finite gain amplifier has very high input impedance. Very high input impedance is nothing but Ri, or Zi is equal to infinite, which is nothing but input is acting as open circuit. So current flowing through input side is zero. So entire current will go through this feedback only. So Ii will goes into Z. No current is flows into finite gain amplifier N, because it has very large input impedance. Large input impedance, you can think it as ideally infinite, so that it acts as open circuit. Otherwise, practically the current flowing into input terminals of amplifier is negligible. Entire current is flowing through impedance Z, that is feedback impedance. So now we can write, okay, V input is nothing but, you can write in this way. So voltage drop across this one is nothing but current flowing through this Ii. How do you write Ii equation? Okay, I'll write over here. Ii, current flowing through this one, Ii can be written as Ii, current flowing through feedback impedance Ii, is nothing but voltage drop across that feedback impedance Z, okay, divided by the Z. So voltage by impedance, that you can write it as voltage difference is going to be Vi minus V naught divided by Z. And we are only interested in the input impedance, so we should get a ratio of Vi by Ii. So take Vi common from this one, Vi times of 1 minus V naught divided by Vi in divided by Z, and it has given that one, this finite gain amplifier has a gain of K. So gain of K implies nothing but gain of K, which is nothing but K is equal to V naught by V input. So V naught by V input can be written as K. So Vi into 1 minus K divided by Z. And now Ii is equal to, this is what Ii, and Zin is equal to Vi divided by Ii, that is equal to Ii will come over here and it will go this side, Z divided by 1 minus K. So this is the input impedance of the given circuit, Z by 1 minus K. So the right answer for this question is D. Thank you.